See, Selenium class 28, Test NG framework part 1. In this chapter, we are going to discuss four topics. First one, Introduction to Test NG. Introduction to Test NG. Next, install TestNG and write first TestNG test case. Install TestNG and write first TestNG test case. Next, third topic, create multiple test cases and run. Create multiple test cases and run. Next, execute multiple programs or classes using XML. See, somebody system making noise. Avoid the disturbance. Gurunath Natarajan, put mute. See, execute multiple test case, multiple programs, Java programs or classes using XML. Gurunath, put mute. Gurunath. Okay. Why you joined twice? Okay, just a minute. See, first one, introduction to TestNG. See, in Selenium using Java, there are two testing frameworks available. One is JUnit, another is TestNG. We can use any one of the frameworks, not both. JUnit, older one. TestNG is advanced version. Advanced one. Inspired by JUnit, but introduced some new features. See, in our training program, we will discuss TestNG. It is similar to JUnit, but advanced framework. See, in Selenium using Java platform, suppose if we use .NET platform, frameworks different, NUnit. If we use Java platform, two frameworks available, JUnit, TestNG. You can use any one of the frameworks, either JUnit or TestNG. In Selenium using Java, there are two testing frameworks. One is JUnit, another is TestNG. Here NG stands for next generation. Neladri, have any idea TestNG testing framework?
Yes, sir. Using TestNG framework, we can result reporting, we can execute the class.
Result reporting is first, or executing is first? Execution is first. Maintain
execution
the
is first.
sequence. Maintain the
Yes.
sequence. Creating test cases, grouping test cases, executing
Yes.
test batches, series of tests. Next.
Yes.
Last one, generating results. Generating results.
Yes.
Test results. Okay, see.
Yes.
See the points. TestNG is a testing framework. Testing framework designed to simplify a broad range of testing needs, from unit testing to system testing. TestNG not only for system testing. Actually, it is created for unit testing, but nowadays it can be used for all levels of testing. Unit testing, developers use TestNG for unit testing, integration testing and system testing and acceptance testing also. Initially developed for unit testing, now used for all kinds of testing, means all levels of testing. And TestNG is open source framework, where NG stands for next generation. Next, TestNG inspired from JUnit and NUnit .NET platform, but introduced some new functionalities that make it more powerful and easier to use. Observe the points. TestNG is a testing framework designed to simplify a broad range of testing needs. From unit testing to system testing. From unit testing to system testing. Our area is system testing. Next, initially developed for unit testing. Now used for all kinds of testing. Next, TestNG is an open source framework. TestNG is an open source freeware, open source framework, where NG stands for next generation. Next point, TestNG inspired from JUnit developed for Java platform and NUnit, NUnit for .NET platform. But introduced some new functionalities. New functionalities. Just a minute. That make it more powerful. That make it more powerful. And easier to use. See, this is a brief introduction about TestNG framework. Next, advantages of TestNG. Part of this first topic, advantages. Advantages of TestNG. Can you tell me, Sanjida, advantages of TestNG?
Sir, advanced reporting feature. And test group testing,
group
execution,
test.
And executions of batch run, and creating test case.
See, first you told result reporting, next at the end creating test cases. Is it sequence? Is it correct sequence?
Yes, sir.
Maintain the sequence.
Okay,
see, whenever you explain any topic, just maintain the sequence.
Okay, sir.
Okay. See, TestNG annotations. Here we use annotations. I will introduce annotations in our examples. TestNG annotations are easy to create test cases. See, TestNG annotations are easy to create test cases. See, this is one advantage. Next, test cases can be grouped and prioritized. Priority. First priority, second priority, one priority, two priority, three. First we have to execute login. Next, fund transfer. Next, bill payments. Next, logout. Like priorities. See, grouping is different, prioritizing is different. Both are combined, but grouping is different. Grouping is means we make a set of test cases, but prioritizing means execution order. Test cases can be grouped and prioritized. Test cases can be grouped and prioritized. More easily. Grouped and prioritized more easily. Next, supports parameterization. Supports parameterization. Next, supports data-driven testing. Say, we use parameterization feature in data-driven testing, but difference is there. Parameterization means passing single value or passing multiple values. But data driven testing means passing multiple values only. Parameterization is global concept. Data driven testing is local concept. See, both are related, but difference is there. Parameterization is superior. Supports data driven testing. Why I am explaining? You can ask, what is the difference between parameterization and data driven testing? Both are same now. No, both are not same. We use parameterization feature in data driven testing, but data driven testing is different. Parameterization is different. Parameterization means passing parameters instead of constant values, means fixed values. You can pass single value or multiple values, but data driven testing means passing multiple values only. Passing single value meaningless. Getting this point, Neladri? Difference between parameterization and data driven testing?
Yes, sir.
See, in user defined methods, we pass single values. Now we use parameters, we pass single values. That is also parameterization. In data driven testing, we pass multiple values. That is also parameterization. Parameterization is global, data driven testing is local. See, supports data driven testing using data providers. What is data provider? It is annotation, I will explain later. Data providers. Next, generates HTML reports. Generates HTML reports. Okay, before this, executes multiple programs, or you can say classes. Execute multiple programs or classes using XML. Did you understand this concept, Gurunath Natarajan?
Got it, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Welcome. Execute multiple programs. Observe, up to now we created and executed so many Java programs. Program, class.
Yes, sir.
Only one program at a time, na?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Not multiple programs at a time. One program at a time. But using TestNG, you can execute multiple programs at a time. At a time means continuously. Neladri, getting?
Yes, sir.
Any confusion, Neladri? Execute
yes, sir. No,
multiple
no,
programs
no,
at a time.
Yes, sir.
Sir. Classes using XML. What is that?
Using XML file, we perform this activity.
Sir, you are going to show that, right?
Yes.
How we?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Okay.
See, observe our fourth concept. What is this fourth concept? Observe this one. Already mentioned. Na? What is this one?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Executing multiple programs or classes or programs or class using XML. Yes, I will show the practical. No issue. Generate HTML reports. Next, parallel test execution. Is possible, but it uses single machine, multiple nodes. Next, readily support integration with other tools. Say, supports integration integration with other tools and plugins. Other tools and plugins. For example, Eclipse. You can integrate with Eclipse IDE. Next, build tools like ANT, Maven, etc. See, these are the important advantages of TestNG. See, final conclusion. Using TestNG, we can create test cases, we can create test cases. Next, group test cases, group test cases. Next, prioritize. Prioritize test cases. See, final conclusion. Execute test cases. Next, and generate test reports. Generate test reports. Sunil, are you there? No, Sunil. Okay. Can you tell me, Aarti, advantage of TestNG? Advantage of TestNG. In our automation using Selenium. TestNG has another advantages. It can be used for unit testing and integration testing also. Our area is system testing, test automation using Selenium. Continue.
It generates HTML test reports.
See,
TestNG
just a minute. Several times I told, generating reports last activity.
Okay.
First activity.
Sorry.
Every time.
TestNG annotation are easy to create test cases. Cases can be grouped and prioritized more easily. We can have a parallel testing is possible. Parameterization is possible. It supports data driven testing using. Execute multiple programs, classes using XML, support integration with other tools and plugins, for example, Eclipse IDE and Maven, etc.
Okay.
And last, it generates HTML test reports.
Okay. See, okay, now Sanjita Mukul, are you following?
Yes, sir, I'm following.
See. Next topic. See, first topic, theoretical topic. Second topic, install TestNG and write first test case. Install TestNG and write first TestNG test case. First TestNG. Test case. See, first I will explain theoretical steps, then I will show the practical. In Eclipse, see, in our test automation using Selenium, we use all open source software. Eclipse is open source, Java open source, Selenium web driver, Selenium tools open source, next TestNG also open source. In Eclipse IDE, in Eclipse IDE, go to help menu, help menu. Help menu, next, install new software, select the menu item, install new software, next, click add, follow the steps, Smita. Then you have to guide me. Click add. Next, enter name as TestNG. Enter name as TestNG. Next, enter URL. You need to remember this URL. Enter URL as http://bust. B-E-U-S-T. You need to remember this URL. bust.com/eclipse. See, this is the URL for downloading TestNG software for Eclipse. Next, select TestNG. Select TestNG. Next, click next. 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 Accept the agreement. Accept the agreement. Next, finish. See, these are the steps for installing TestNG framework in Eclipse IDE. See, launch Eclipse. Just a minute. Just a minute. Guide me, Smita. Launch TestNG. Okay, launched. Next. Sorry, launch Eclipse IDE. Launched. Next.
Help menu.
Help menu.
Install new software.
Yes, install new software.
Click add.
Click add.
Click add.
Click add. Next.
Enter name as TestNG.
TestNG. Just a minute. TestNG. Next,
URL as http colon
already available. Continue remaining
slash
bust.com
slash
eclipse
forward slash.
Okay, next, click OK.
Click OK.
See, TestNG populated na. Next step.
Select TestNG.
Select TestNG.
Click next.
Click next. Bottom.
Bottom.
Click next. Just wait. See, observe the status bar, Gurnath. Bottom.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I'm able to see, sir.
Okay, again next. Next.
Agreement, accept the agreement.
Accept the agreement and finish. finish. Say, installing software. Installing, just a minute. Just a minute. It is in test ng installing. It is taking too much time. See, without test ng also, observe Neladri, without test ng also, we created multiple test cases in a program, na? Day before yesterday, Neladri, Sridevi, Neladri, we create we created and executed multiple test cases in a program using user defined methods, na?
Yes sir.
Just a minute. Why it is taking too much time? See, you will need to restart Eclipse for the changes to take effect. Yes. See Eclipse launching. Okay. Sanjida Mukul, you tell me the navigation once again. How to install TestNG in Eclipse IDE? First launch Eclipse IDE, then?
Then navigate to help.
Help menu.
Help menu, then install software.
Install new software.
And add.
Click add.
Yes sir. And test ng name.
Enter test ng. Next location. What is the URL? beust.com/eclipse. Next, it will populate test ng. Select test ng. Next. Accept the agreement and finish. Okay.
Yes, sir.
After just a minute, help menu, installation details. Abzar Smita, test ng available na? Installation details.
Yes, sir.
If you want to uninstall test ng, uninstall. Here you can uninstall. Abzar bottom, uninstall option is there na?
Yes, sir.
Uninstall and update. Update option is there and uninstall option also there. How to uninstall Gurunath Natarajan? How to uninstall TestNG?
So go to help select menu.
Help menu.
Install details, sir.
Installation details. Here and select SystemG. Next.
Then we can click on uninstall or update, sir.
Uninstall.
On what.
Uninstall. If you want to update, you can update. Okay, close.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, welcome. See. Installation. Mm-hmm. I think all of you are familiar with installation of TestNG in Eclipse. Next, write first TestNG test case. Write first TestNG test case. See. Write first TestNG test case. See, first I will explain manual test case. Simple test case, manual test case. See, just verify title of the page. Verify title of the page. See, this is our manual test case. Test case name. Verify title of the page. Next, test steps. Test steps. First step, launch the browser. Launch the browser. Next, navigate to gmail.com. Navigate to gmail.com. gmail.com. These are the general steps, normal steps. Next, verification point. Say, capture the page title and compare with expected. Capture the page title and compare with expected. Next, expected. Next, actual after execution. Next, status, result status, pass or fail after execution only. First take expected. gmail.com. See, redirecting. How to get page title, Preeti? Preeti?
Yes, sir.
How to get the page title, web page title?
Using get driver.get
title. I am not capturing. How to get means manually. I want to take expected.
Use the firebug.
Firebug. Firebug.
And then use the arrow.
Arrow.
And there in Gmail. On Gmail. Yeah.
You guide me, Neeladri, how to get page title? See, very simple. at top of the page, left side top of the page. So
yes sir,
it is showing tooltip now. Can you observe this tooltip?
Yes sir.
Gmail, it is showing now.
Mm-hmm.
Another way, see, place mouse pointer on the web page, view page source.
On the top of the page title.
Just a minute, here, title. What is the
Gmail.
Title tag?
Gmail.
Gmail. Okay, now Preeti, any confusion?
No, sir, I'm good. Thanks.
Okay, see, Gmail. Next, write test ng test case. See, test ng test case. Create new class. Create new class. Class. Suppose verify page title okay. Next, say in testng every test case is method and we use test annotation @ test annotation. Here every test case is method and we use test annotation. See, it is showing red color. Sanjida, why it is showing red color marking? Underline.
Sir, we need to import sir.
Libraries.
Yes, sir.
It is not showing anyone. Okay, first create. You know the method syntax. Method syntax. Suppose.
Sir. In testng, we don't create project directly. We create a class only, right?
We don't create
project.
Project already there. Package already there, na?
I think she just wanted to know. We don't have to write main method.
See, main method is different case. I will explain. No main method in testng programs. She is asking project and package.
Driver.
Project already there.
Okay.
Package already there. Under the package only we can create classes. Without project package
okay.
We can't create class.
Okay.
See, we cannot create classes directly in Java, isn't it? What is the sequence of creating classes?
Yes.
First project, next package, next class.
And then class.
Already,
yes.
Already project is there. Observe this one, left side, top. Selenium testing is the project name. Next, Selenium WebDriver is the package. Under this package, we created class. What is the class? Verify page title dot Java. Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
Already there. That's why I just created the class. Otherwise, you need to create project. Yes. Package, then class.
Yeah, that is why I ask you.
Already there. See, public void, suppose, verify title. Open curly braces, close curly braces. See, WebDriver driver equal to new Firefox driver, open and close parenthesis, semicolon. Next, import WebDriver libraries. Next, import Firefox driver. Just a minute. What is the problem? Share observe test. See, it is not showing context help properly. Import test org testng annotations. Next, import Firefox driver. Next, continue Gurunath Natarajan. You know the steps now for Gmail.
Sir, driver dot get.
See, driver dot get. Within double quotes.
HTTPS.
Just a minute. See gmail.com. Next, see normal steps over. Next, capture page title. How to capture page title? See, title is string type data. Title is string type data. String.
String, you can declare any variables or
variable. Suppose page. Title, any meaningful name you can use, equal to
driver dot
get title.
Get title, yes, sir.
Get title, semicolon.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next, generally we use conditional statements, but here yes, we have to use testng assert methods. Assertion methods. See,
okay.
Assert, it is built in class assert dot type assert equals. Assert equals. Assert equals. Observe, it is showing now. Why it is? Just a minute. Is imported JUnit. Assert. Still. TestNG annotations. Okay. Assert. Dot asset equals. Asset equals. Asset equals of. Since observe Neeladri, same assertion methods available in JUnit also. Here, what is the actual value? Actual value, Neeladri?
Gmail, sir.
Page title.
No, page title.
Page title.
Page title. Next, expected is Gmail.
Gmail.
Just run the program. See testng running. See verify page title. Test runs one. observe Preeti, status of result. Passed na?
Yes, sir.
Just a minute.
I have a quick question, sir. This is Gurunath, sir. What page titles and expected as wise page titles, sir?
We are capturing the data now from application. Here, observe.
Oh, yeah, I got it. Okay.
That is expected.
Yes, sir. Okay.
See, we don't know the expectation. We don't know the expected value. After execution only, you can get the expected value. Sorry, actual value.
Yes, sir. Got it, sir.
See,
yes,
sir. We prepare expected value. We prepare expected value. Tester need to prepare expected value. But actual value, when we get actual value? After execution only, na?
Yes, sir. Got it, sir. Thank
we
you, sir.
Are capturing page title. Then page title is the actual. Gmail is expected. We already prepared that one. Just a minute. Refresh. Just select this one. Refresh. Where is that one?
Sir?
Ah.
Yeah, select the project, project and refresh.
Ah, yes, yes, yes. Just a minute. Observe Gurunath, left side bottom, test output folder created now.
Yes, sir. Got it, sir. Test output folder, yes, sir.
Here, you can view the result. See, emailable report is there. Next.
Yes, sir. Testing reports, yes, sir.
Pardon?
Testing results. There are results, sir. Testing dash reports, CSS, testing.xml.
Not XML, HTML.
Index HTML, sir.
This is emailable report. Just a minute. Neladri, where is that report? Index. Open with HTML editor. No.
Sir, we have to make right click on the emailable report. Right click on emailable report. And open with.
I already did that. Open with.
Sir, web browser.
Web browser. Web browser. Yes, web browser. Not HTML. Next, index. Index open with web browser.
Oh, okay. Open with. Okay, index open with.
See, observe Gurunath, it is showing na one method. Here every method is one test case. Passed na, verify title.
Sir, can you show it again, sir, if you don't mind, sir? Previously there was one report. Yeah, this, how did you get this report, sir?
Just a minute.
Yes, sir.
See, project, package, class. This is TestNG program. Just run the program. Run the program. See TestNG running. See passed.
Yes, sir.
Next, you select project and refresh. Refresh. Here, bottom, test output folder is there, na?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You collapse the test output. Next, here, index.html file is there, na?
Yes,
right,
sir. Yes, sir.
Right click, open with web browser. See, result. Next, one more thing. One more file, emailable report is there, na? Right click, open with web browser. This is emailable. See, just you copy this one. You copy. This is emailable. You can send this emailable file as attachment. Observe. Suppose I am pasting this one.
Okay,
on desktop. Sir. This is emailable. You can attach.
The results, sir.
Then what is the problem?
No, sir. I was not able to follow where to click, right click, sir. So I did not get, sir. Now I got it. Thank you.
Okay, welcome. Observe Sanjida. Following the steps now, Sanjida?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Got it.
Just a minute. I will. Say after that you write this one also, driver dot close. Observe Sridevi, in TestNG every test case is method. We use test at the rate test annotation. Here main method not used, that I will explain. Before that, observe, here we used TestNG annotation. See, TestNG contribution is there in this test case. Next, Selenium contribution. See, driver get Selenium contribution. Next, Java contribution also there. Sridevi, where is Java contribution in this test case?
Sir, like public, class, import.
Okay, that is Java class or Java program. In our test case, observe this one. This is selected area. In our test case, where is the Java contribution? Can you
data
tell me,
type.
Rahman, in this test case, where is the Java contribution?
It's a get title.
Get title.
String.
String. String is there now. Observe Niladri. String. This is a string. This string belongs to Java now.
Yes, there are lots of things like public, void,
okay.
This is also on Java.
Actually, public, void, keywords also belongs to Java, but here I am saying direct usage. We use a string. Public, void also belongs to Java, Java syntax. Here direct usage is string. We are capturing value to string. String belongs to Java. Next, assert dot assert equals.
This is TestNG.
TestNG. Driver dot close.
This is Selenium concept.
Selenium web driver. Selenium web driver. Observe. Observe Preeti once again. This selected area. Selected area. This is test case. In TestNG, every method is one test case. Here we use at the rate test. See, selected one, at the rate test. What is this one?
Test annotation.
Next, this public void verify title, selected statement. This is
Java.
Method syntax, Java method syntax.
Yes, sir.
Next line. Creating Firefox driver belongs to this web driver now. Next,
yes.
Driver dot get selected statement belongs to Selenium web driver now.
Yes.
Next.
Java
plus web driver contribution also there now. See, up to this equal to Java. Driver dot get title.
Web methods.
Pardon?
Methods. Java methods.
Java methods. Driver dot get title Java method.
No, it is Selenium.
Selenium WebDriver method. See, in this 15th line, Java and Selenium WebDriver. Next, 16th line.
A test annotation.
Test NG. Okay.
Test NG.
Next, 17th line.
Selenium method.
Selenium WebDriver. Okay. See. See test NG, test case. See note. Main method is not used. Main method is not used for test NG programs, for test NG programs. Observe Gurunath Natarajan, in test NG programs, no main method. Actually, what Sir. Is the purpose of main method in Java? In Java programs, what is the purpose of main method in Java programs?
The beginning of the program,
beginning of the program. Neeladri, what is the purpose of main method in Java?
To execute the program.
Execution starts from main method.
Yes, sir. Execution. Yes, sir.
Program execution starts from main method. But in test NG yes, programs, no main method. Test NG can execute. See, that is built-in facility. No main method. Next, test NG programs contains only methods that contain test annotations. See, test NG programs. Test NG programs contain only methods. Methods test NG program contains only methods that contain at the rate test annotations. Next, if we don't write at the rate test annotation, then the method is not going to be executed. If you don't write at the rate test annotation, then the method is not going to be executed. See, these are the points. Okay, now Sanjida, Smita, writing first test NG program.
Yes, sir.
Next, third one.
Sir, can you turn the letter off? I want to write the number 2, please.
Pardon?
Can you do a little? Oh, yeah, thank you.
Test NG program contains. Next, third topic. Write multiple test cases. Write multiple test cases in a program. Say, just I am going to use some dummy test cases. You try to understand the concept, how to write multiple test cases in TestNG program say. Suppose just a minute, multiple test cases. See, this is one test case. Just dummy test cases. You can use real test cases also. We will discuss. Next, verify. Suppose verify title. Next, ABCD. Next, XYZ. This is test case name.
On line 14, there is a extra O. Oh, I don't know if it's metal for us telling.
A, B, C, D. Observe. Here, every method is one test case. Every method is one test case. How many test cases are there in this program? How many test cases are there, Gurnad? We need to write test annotation for every method.
Three of them are there, sir.
See, three. Run three test cases. One failure. Runs three, one failure. Which one?
I think the Yahoo, you have a wrong spelling, looks like, sir.
Okay. Run. See, three. Three test cases passed. Observe, Neeladri. What is the first test case? Test case name?
First test case is ABCD, sir.
ABCD. No, verify title. As per this program, what is the first test case?
ABCD, sir.
Not ABCD. As per this program, first test case ABCD.
Execution starts from ABCD.
Execution flow, forget about that one. That is alphabetical order. As per our program, TestNG program, what is the first test case?
Verify title.
Verify title is the first test case. Next, ABCD is second one. XYZ is last one. But how it is executing? Just a minute. Why only one? Just a minute. Three. This is the execution sequence. ABCD, verify title, XYZ. It executes alphabetical order. Alphabetical order. See, just a minute. Suppose this is the TestNG program. This is the TestNG program. In this TestNG program, we wrote multiple test cases. See, test cases as per program. First, verify title. Next, ABCD. Next, XYZ. Next, execution flow. Execution flow. Alphabetical order. First, ABCD. Next, verify title. Observe Smita, last one, XYZ. See conclusion. Test NG test cases are executed in alphabetical order. See test NG. Test NG test cases are executed in alphabetical order. See somebody systematic, nice, avoid that one. Alphabetical order. Next, if you want to control the test execution process, then use priority attribute. See, if you want to control, if you want to control the test execution process, then use priority attribute. This is test annotation attribute. Observe. Example. Observe Smita, I want first verify title. Say actually in our, as per our program, test case sequence is verify title ABCD XYZ, but as per alphabetical order, test NG program executes first ABCD, next verify title, next XYZ. But I want program sequence only. For that you can follow priority process. Getting na?
Yes, sir.
Here use priority numbers. See, at the rate test at open curly braces priority equal to 1. Next, priority 2. Next, priority 3. Now observe the test execution flow. Observe Smita, first verify title, next ABCD, last XYZ na?
Yes, sir.
See, this is priority attribute. Okay, na Neeladri, priority?
Yes, sir.
Suppose here one test case fails. Yahoo. Google. Run the program.
Sir.
Ah.
I'm sorry. I just remember this. So I just probably you forget to upload yesterday's file.
Okay. I will send after the class.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Now observe, Smita, test case failed na? Two passed, one failed na? Next, instead of priority, you can use depends on methods attribute. See, depends on methods. O capital letter, M capital letter. Depends on methods, attribute. Instead of priority, see. Instead of priority, priority attribute we can use depends on methods. Depends on methods attribute. Okay, I will show the example. See, first, just a minute. At the rate test, it is showing again. At the rate, okay, complete the syntax. Public void. Suppose login dummy test case, suppose SYSO control space enter login successful. Just I am writing dummy test case, you can use real test cases also, we'll discuss. This is first test case, login. Next, log out. Next, search. Next, advanced search. Advanced search. See. Advanced search. Successful. Advanced search successful. Search successful. Suppose log out successful. See how many test cases are there, Gurnad, in this program? How many test cases?
Four are there, sir.
Four test cases. Run the program. If you run the program, what will happen? It will execute alphabetical order, na?
Yes, sir. First, fourth one will be executed.
First, advanced search. Next, login, then log out,
login,
search.
Sir.
Run the program. See, four test cases. See, first, advanced search, login, log out, search. But I want login first, search second, advanced search third, log out fourth, using priority attribute. Guide me, Sridevi. Login first, log out last, search second one, advanced search third one, using priority attribute.
Yes, sir. Login priority equal to 1.
See, priority equals to 1. Just a minute, not here, at the rate test annotation. Next.
Search priority 2.
Search priority 2. Next, advanced search priority 3.
In logout.
Next,
priority
logout 4. Run the program. Observe login search, advanced search logout. Just a minute. First one, using priority attribute. Using priority attribute. Next, same sequence using depends on methods attribute. Depends on method attribute. Say first one, login, leave it. Suppose this is the first priority, leave it, no dependency for login. Next, second one, search. For search depends on, see, observe Neeladri, depends on methods. Depends on methods equal to, within curly braces, follow the syntax, curly braces and double quotes. What is the depends on method?
Login, sir.
Login. Login is the depends method. Close. Next, for advanced search, what is the depends on method?
Search.
Next, last one, for logout. Logout. Where is the logout? Here. What is that depends on method? Advanced search. Smita, are you following?
Yes, sir.
First
yes,
one, sir, login. For login, no dependency. Next, for search,
login is a dependency.
Login is dependency. Next, for advanced search, search is dependent. Next, for logout, advanced search. Run the program. See, observe. Login, search, advanced search, logout. See, earlier we used priority attribute. This time, depends on methods. Next, just a minute. For example, suppose search, otherwise advanced search. Asset dot asset equals of ABCD XYZ. Run. Say login successful, otherwise you remove this one. Just a minute, we use only testng instead of system output SYSO. Just a minute. Suppose XYZ ABCD ER run the program. Say passed login, failed search. User failed status for search na. Suppose search also passed A B C D. Advanced search failed X Y Z. Run the program. Observe Smita, how many test cases executed?
Three, sir.
Three. Login passed, search passed, advanced search failed. But fourth test case not executed. See, observe. Here skips one. Skipped. Why? Third test depends on methods. Third test case failed na. That's why fourth test case is not executing. Suppose if any functionality dependency, you use depends on methods. Suppose if no functionality dependency, you can use priority.
Okay.
If any functionality dependency is there, you use depends on methods. Otherwise, use priority. Suppose functionality dependency is there for some test cases, for some test cases no functionality dependency, that I want to execute forcibly. Suppose even though advanced search fails, execute logout, for that use always run attribute, one more attribute, comma, always run equal to true. Run the program. Observe how many tests run, Smita? Four na?
Failures
one, skips zero, earlier skips one. Observe four cases executed. Login search, logout, advanced search. Neladri, did you understand this usage?
Sir, can you
just a minute, Gurnath? I am asking.
Yes, sir.
Did you understand this concept?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
For example, instead of this one, if we use priority, what will happen? Priority.
Sir, this is Gurunath here, sir. Previously, only three were executing. Now, four were executing. One of them failed. What change did we make, sir?
You didn't observe.
Sorry, sir.
Concentrate. See, I use it always forcibly.
Okay.
Suppose even though depends on method fail, it will execute.
Okay, got it, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Welcome. See, earlier, advanced search. See, this logout, for this logout test case, advanced search is the precondition.
Yes, depends sir. Yes, sir. Got it.
That's
yes,
earlier I didn't use always run equal to true attribute. That's why
yes, sir. That's
fail
three of them
skipped.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Thank you so much, sir.
Welcome. See, observe this one. For example, instead of this one, instead of this one if we use priority. Instead of this one, if we use priority, suppose priority 1, priority 2, next, priority 3, next, oh, priority 3, this one, no? Priority 3, this is priority 2, this is priority 4. Run the program. No skips. Failure 1. Suppose first one XYZA. Run. 2 failures. Skips 0. Observe Sanjida. If you use priority, what is happening? What about advanced search? Failed. Executed 4. If we use priority, what will happen? No skips. You tell me the Neeladri conclusion. If we use priority attribute. Priority.
If
we use priority attribute, then all test cases, all test cases can be executed. No skips. Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
Same scenario. If we use depends on methods. Depends on O capital, next M capital, depends on methods attribute, then what will happen?
It will fail.
No failures. Okay, skips. Then
It will skips the depends method after the depend methods.
Test cases. When it will skip? It will skip
whenever
depends on methods. Test case fails. See, if we use depends on methods attribute, then it will skip the test case. Then it will skip the test case. Whenever depends on methods, test case fails. Okay, na? But if you use priority attribute, no skips, it will execute. Then what is the problem if it executes? If any functionality dependency is there, then problem na? See, continuation, test case fails. If you want to execute the test case, forcibly, then use always, if no functionality dependency, then use always run attribute. A final conclusion. Tell me, Neeladri, when to choose priority attribute, when to choose depends on methods attribute.
Priority method attributes use when we don't need any, when there is any dependency needed.
See, suppose if there is any, if there is no functionality dependency, then use priority attribute. Okay, na? Next, if there is any functionality dependency, then use at the rate, depends on methods attribute. Getting the point, Sanjida Mukul, any confusion?
No, sir.
Suppose in our program, some test cases are there, functionality dependency is there, then we used depends on methods attribute, but one test case failed, next test case skipped, but for next test case no functionality dependency, for remaining all test cases functionality dependency is there. If you want to execute that particular test case, skipped test case forcibly, then how to execute? Mukul. Getting my question?
No, sir. Can you repeat it, sir? Sir, pardon.
This is always running.
Yes, always run attribute. See, observe the three scenarios. First scenario, no functionality dependency. See, just a minute. Scenario one, no functionality dependency. Then, which one is the preferable, Sanjida? Priority or depends on methods?
Priority.
Priority attribute. See, use priority attribute. Okay. No functionality dependency. Use priority attribute. Next, scenario two. Functionality dependency. Dependency is there. Then use depends on methods attribute. These two scenarios you can easily understand. Next one, typical scenario. Typical scenario. Scenario three. See, functionality dependency for some test cases only. For some test cases only. Suppose if any test case fails, then it won't execute next test case. Getting the point, Sanjida?
Yes, sir.
If any test case fails, it won't execute next test case if we use depends on methods. Suppose in my program 10 test cases are there, functionality dependency is there, but 8th test case failed, 9th skipped, but in between 8 and 9 no functionality dependency, but in between 1 and 2, 2 and 3, 3 and 4 functionality dependency is there, But in between 8 and 9, no functionality dependency. But when we use depends on method, definitely 9th case will be skipped. But I don't want to skip 9th test case. Why? No functionality dependency between 8th and 9. I want to execute 9th test case forcibly. Then, how to execute? Tell me, Niladri.
Always true.
Use depends on methods and
run.
Always true. Always run. Okay, true is the value. Always run attributes. Any confusion, Sanjida?
No, sir.
But why are not saying this one, always run attribute? Now you tell me, Gurunath Natarajan.
Sir.
Any confusion?
Got it, sir. Thank you. No, sir. No confusion, sir.
I explained three scenarios. Na? First scenario, yes, no functionality dependency. All are independent test cases. All are independent test cases. Then use priority attribute. What is the advantage?
Yes,
what is the advantage? If any test case fails, it won't skip next test case.
Yes, sir.
It will execute all test cases, even though some test cases fail. Next, scenario 2, functionality dependency. Suppose in our program some test cases are there, functionality dependency is there. For second test case, first case must be passed. For third, second case must be passed. That time use depends on methods. If any test case fails, it won't execute next test case.
Yes, sir.
Next, typical scenario, third one, suppose in our program some test cases are there, functionality dependency also there, but not for all test cases, only for some test cases. Suppose 4 test cases are there, in between 1 and 2 dependency, 2 and 3 dependency is there, but 3 and 4 no dependency, but third test case failed, fourth automatically skipped. I don't want to skip fourth test case. That time you have to use always run equal to true, that attribute.
Yes, sir.
Okay, na?
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Welcome. Preeti. Any confusion, Preeti?
No, sir. I'm good. Thank you.
Okay. Say, next, I will introduce two more annotations. Before that, you make web driver test cases, simple test cases, observe Niladri. I want first launch browser. Next, verify. Gmail page title. This is one test case. Test cases. First one, launch browser. Second, verify Gmail page. If you want to verify Gmail page, first you need to navigate to Gmail home, then verify Gmail page. After that, simple test cases. Verify Yahoo homepage. Verify Yahoo homepage. Next, close browser. Okay, dependency, first one launch browser, after that execute Gmail, then execute Yahoo, then close browser. TestNG program. Guide me, Preeti, TestNG program. Suppose I'm creating new class. Don't ask how you are creating class directly. Project already there, package also there. Under this package, I'm creating class. Suppose TestNG program. No main method, just finish. Guide me. First launch browser. Next verify Gmail page title. Next verify Yahoo home page title. Verify Gmail home page title. Yahoo home page title. Then close browser. Simple test cases. Guide me, Preeti.
First launch the browser.
Driver. First launch the browser. How to launch? Write test annotations.
At the rate.
Just a minute. At the rate.
Test. Web driver.
Directly web driver. Every test annotation, every test is method na?
Yes, public.
Public. Suppose return type nothing. Void.
Launch browser. Open and curly bracket. Now we have to create
just
a
import TestNG annotation. Observe Gurunath Natarajan. Here test annotation available in TestNG and also JUnit na.
Yes sir.
Don't import from JUnit. Here TestNG. Select TestNG. Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Welcome. Next, continue, Preeti.
Then driver. Create a driver.
Driver. How to create driver? Web driver.
Web driver.
Suppose if you write web driver in this method, what about next method? In the next method also you need to create the driver again na?
Yes sir.
This is block of code na. See, we are using curly braces. If you use curly braces, that usage is restricted to that particular block na?
Yes sir, we have to make
you create driver. You create driver globally.
Yes.
Before test, create driver globally. Public. Web driver. Public, web driver, driver.
The static should be
not required. You would import this one, web driver. Now tell me, Preeti, continue.
Yeah, driver equal to?
Driver equals to new Firefox driver, open and close curly braces, semicolon. Import Firefox driver. Enough na? For launch browser.
Yes sir.
Next, verify Gmail page. Suppose
public void.
Just a minute. Name. Verify Gmail page. Open curly braces, close.
Driver dot. Get.
Okay, good. See here.
And then
provide the URL.
Yeah.
URL. Just a minute. Suppose Gmail. Next.
Then we have to store the value.
Capture the value, na?
Yes, string.
Otherwise, directly capture and compare.
Yeah, asset dot.
See, simplify the code. Asset dot.
Asset equals.
Asset equals. Just
then
a
in
minute.
Bracket Gmail.
Just a minute. Asset dot asset equals. Oh, it is capturing. It is taking that J units. Just a minute. You type entire thing. Asset dot.
Asset equals.
Asset equals. EQUALS. Of. Expected. What is the expected?
Gmail.
Expected is Gmail. Just a minute. Oh, again. Again, it is taking J unit. Just a minute. Import testng. Now tell me, Gurnath, actual. Say earlier we captured that value into string, then used that string. This time directly.
Yes, sir. Gmail, sir. Gmail, sir.
Gmail, comma. Gmail, comma. Sanjida Mukul, Gmail, comma. Capture
Gmail
and compare,
sir.
Directly.
Yes, sir. Gmail only, net, sir.
Sir.
Just a minute. Sanjida. Gurnath, your turn over. Just Sanjida.
Yes, sir.
Gmail, comma. Capture and compare.
Gmail, comma. Gmail, sir.
Smita.
Driver.
Title,
sir.
Driver dot.
Get.
Get title. Okay. Observe Sanjida. See, this is a simple way. Instead of this, first you can capture the value and compare. Otherwise, you can directly write Selenium WebDriver step, na?
Yes, sir.
Any confusion, Gurnath Natarajan?
Driver dot get title. We are directly using. Previously used to the string.
Previously, first. Previously, one more step. Okay, that is understandable. First, capturing the value into string, then comparing. This time,
yes, sir.
Capturing and comparing directly.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, welcome. Next, continue, Preeti. Mainstream, Preeti. Verify Yahoo title. Public void verify Yahoo page. Open curly braces. Continue, Preeti. Continue. Now verify Yahoo page.
And then driver dot.
Observe or verify Gmail home. Next Yahoo page. Next close browser. driver dot
get
here provide
URL.
Yahoo URL. Yahoo URL. Just a minute. This is the URL. This is the URL. Next, expected. Take the expected. What is the expected? Preeti, continue, Preeti.
Yahoo.
Yahoo. Yahoo is the expected. You are in silent mode. Okay.
Sorry.
Okay, cool. Suppose assert equals. Yahoo dot sorry dot, Yahoo
yeah.
comma
then driver dot get title
next close one more curly brace semicolon one more parenthesis semicolon. Next, last one, and just a minute.
Close the browser.
Every method is one test case. Use test annotation. Yes. Test annotation. Next, close browser. Last one, close browser. Suppose
public void.
Public void close.
Close browser.
Close browser off. Open curly
open
brace. No arguments.
Driver yes. dot close.
Driver dot close. See, observe four test cases. Observe Niladri. As per program, what is the sequence? As per program, first launch browser, next. Verify Gmail, next verify Yahoo, then close browser. But as per all, it will execute alphabetical order. As per alphabetical order, first close browser na?
Yes, sir.
Close browser or launch browser? First close browser. Next?
Launch browser.
Next launch browser, next verify Gmail, next verify Yahoo. But that is not the sequence na? Here dependency is there na? Functionality dependency is there.
Yes, sir.
Use priority attribute. Priority. First priority. Priority equal to 1. This is 1. Next. Priority 2. Next. Priority 3. Close browser priority 4. Run the program. See test ng running. See observe run 4. Failures 0. Observe launch browser, verify Gmail, verify Yahoo, close browser. Okay, now Sanjida, observe that selected one.
Yes, sir.
How to view the test HTML report?
Right click of project name.
Just select project, refresh. And yes, right click, refresh.
Yes, sir.
Here test output folder is there na bottom.
Yes,
collapse this folder. Here index HTML is there na. Select this index HTML. Open with web browser. Here showing na. Next, emailable report.
Same way.
Same way. Web browser. This is emailable report. But it is showing in alphabetical order. Priority. We used priority. Just a minute. You can use priority also, but one problem is there if you use priority. Functionality dependency is there now. For example, if Gmail fails, suppose, observe, my expectation is Gmail A. This is my expectation. This is my expectation. Okay, here no functionality dependency, na? No functionality dependency. Priority will work. Instead of this, use depends on methods. Depends on methods equal to open curly braces, close curly braces. Open curly braces, close curly braces. Not for this first one, launch browser. For second one, launch browser. Next, for third one, observe Arti, for third one, depends on methods. What is that depends on methods? For Yahoo page? First.
Verify Gmail page.
Next, last one, for this one.
Close is after Yahoo.
After Yahoo.
Verify
Yahoo page. Verify Yahoo page. Run the program. Observe. Four. First, launch browser, verify Gmail, verify Yahoo, close browser. Close browser. Okay. This time we use depends on methods. Observe Smita, depends on methods. All passed. Next, suppose if anyone test case fails. Suppose yeah. Then what will happen? Suppose second case fails, what will happen, Smita? Otherwise, suppose second case okay, third case fails. What will happen, Smita?
So failed will be one, sir, the result.
Failed one, but depends on methods na, it will skip last test case na.
Oh yes, sir. The close is interdependent with the Gmail page.
It will skip. Observe, run. Observe, browser not closed na. See, skips one.
Yes,
browser not closed. Why? That launch, only three cases executed. First two passed, third one failed, that's why fourth skipped. See, skips. Which one is skipped?
Yes, sir.
skipped close browser.
Close.
That's why browser not closed. See, observe, still browser available. Suppose in between 3 and 4 test cases, no dependency. 1 and 2 dependency is there. Launch browser. Launch browser is mandatory for Gmail page. Dependency is there. Suppose 2 and 3 no dependency, 3 and 4 no dependency. I want to execute 4th test case forcibly. How to execute?
Always.
Always run. Use always run attribute. How to use always run? After curly braces, use comma.
Use comma, always.
Always run R is capital. Always run equal to?
True.
False is default. Then it will execute all test cases. It won't skip that 4th test case.
So why did it skip 4th test case previously, sir?
Depends na. See, 2 times I explained that concept. Just a minute. Now browser closed na, Smita?
Browser is closed.
See, 3 cases also failed. 3 cases passed. 3 cases passed. 1 case failed. See, actually 3rd case failed, but it executed last test case. Why? We used always run equal to true. Earlier it skipped. Tell me, Gurnath.
I got it, sir. Like previously yahoo.a, it did not close it because of the...
In previous test run, browser
yes,
not
sir.
Closed. 4th test case not executed. Why? 3rd test case failed. 3rd test case failed. This time we used always run equal to true attribute for 4th test case to run forcibly. That's why 4 test cases
okay.
Executed, no skips, but 3 passed, 1 failed. Okay, na?
Good.
Just a minute,
thank
last
you,
2 minutes. Sanjida Mukul, any confusion? Just a minute, last 2 minutes. Observe Preeti. In this example, we use test cases. How many test cases in this example?
4
test cases. We used all 4 test cases as independent test cases. But I am enhancing my requirement. Here only 2 test cases. 2 test cases. What are the 2 test cases? Verify. Just a minute. Verify Gmail homepage. Verify Yahoo homepage. Close browser. Launch browser. See, close browser. Precondition. Close browser is precondition for every test case in this program. Next, this is a post condition. Just a minute. Post condition for every test case. Means what is our required test flow? Required here 2 test cases only. Test execution flow. Can you tell me test execution flow? Smita, test execution flow. First launch browser. Next, verify Gmail homepage. Next,
verify Yahoo.
Close browser. observe here, precondition for every test case, post condition for every test case. This is one sequence. Next, second one.
This launch.
One. Launch again. Launch browser already closed now. Next, execute second test case. Okay, now any confusion?
No, sir.
Launch browser, verify Gmail home. Next, close browser. Next, again launch browser, verify Gmail home, close browser. This is the execution flow. See, for this we use before method, after method, annotations. See, before method, at the rate, just last 2 minutes, at the rate, before method. Next, at the rate, after method, after every method, before every method. This is a precondition for every test case in a class or program. Next, second one, post condition for every, just a minute, post condition for every test case in a class or program. Observe the example. Say here, launch browser before method. Change the annotation. Before method means before every method in this class. Next, close browser after method means after every method in this class. After every method. Next, here you can use just priority or depends on methods. Suppose for Gmail, priority equal to 1, or you can use depends on method also. For Gmail, no depends. If it is first one, before method execute by default. Next, Yahoo. Priority 2. Observe what is the execution flow. What is the test execution flow, Gurnath? Observe the priorities and before method and after method.
Yes, sir. Before method, yes, sir.
What is the execution flow? Launch browser, verify Gmail, close yes, browser. Launch browser, verify Yahoo, close browser. Run the program. Yes, now Gmail. Say slowly. What is the problem? Just a minute. Just a minute. Just a refresh. Run the program. TestNG running. Closed. Next, Yahoo. closed. Earlier that Yahoo not responded properly, this time executed properly. Observe Sanjida Mukul, how many tests?
Three, sir.
Pardon?
Two, sir.
Two tests. Oh.
Three.
Total test runs.
Two, sir.
Two only. Failures one. Okay, forget about failures. See, observe. Verify Gmail. Passed. Verify Yahoo. Failed. Verify Gmail passed. Why here I used?
Because
intentionally I used. Run the program once again. Just refresh. Run the program once again. See, browser launching Gmail, browser closed. Next, browser once again launching Yahoo. Navigating to Yahoo. Next, closed. Observe this time. Total test runs 2. Failures 0. See, observe Smita. Verify Gmail page first passed. Next, verify Yahoo passed na.
Sir.
But here it is not showing launch browser, Gmail, close browser, next launch browser, Yahoo, close browser. But in execution, you can observe, na?
Yes, sir.
Just a minute. This is about before method and after method annotations. Just the last 1 minute. Here,
sir, when you put a Yahoo E, so that time it executed and it was showing a failure, right?
Failure.
Yeah, but it closed the browser also, right? So it will work that way.
After methods, no priority. It will execute definitely.
Okay, sir.
So, see, for before method and after method, no priorities applicable.
Okay, so by default, they will execute,
yes,
that, right?
Yes, by default, they will execute.
Okay, thank you.
Pass or fail is not the criteria. Last 1 minute, observe Smita. Here, we used before method, after method. What is the purpose of before method? It is precondition for every test case in a class or program. After method, precondition for every test case in a class or program. Okay, na? Okay, some more annotations are there. Tomorrow I will show. Now, today we discussed three annotations. What are the three annotations, Sanjida?
After method.
And one more thing. Today we discussed only three topics. Create introduction to TestNG, install TestNG and write first TestNG test case, create multiple test cases and run. But fourth one not discussed. Tomorrow we will continue this fourth one. Execute multiple programs using XML. Okay, na? Niladri, I'm going to close the session. Any queries?
No, sir. Thank you.
Welcome. Sanjida, Aarti, any queries?
No, sir. Thank you.
Welcome.
No,
good night, Natarajan.
No, sir. No, sir. Nothing, sir.
Preeti.
Sir, there will be more annotations, right?
Yes. Today we discussed three only.
Okay, so will you able to send the list of the annotations?
Yes, I will send.
Okay, thank you so much.
Welcome.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, we'll meet tomorrow, same time. Thank you.